With event cancellations and course postponements, some Master Resilience trainers are conducting unit-level training with online teleconference presentations. However, the activations of the 104th and the 224th medical companies provided the first opportunity for classroom training.
So what I like best about being a Master Resilience trainer is that I, as a behavioral health officer, we see a lot of different challenges. Soldiers go through a lot of adversities. And so being a Master Resiliency trainer really gives us a tangible set of skills to give to soldiers to put in their toolbox to help enhance their resilience.
The purpose of this training is used to help soldiers become more resilient both on and off the battlefield.
A person becomes resilient through several things, but some of the main principles that we teach are self-awareness. When we're aware of our thoughts and our emotions and reactions, and know how our interactions and our reactions affect other people.
During this three-day course, 9 students became certified as resilience training assistants.
My one takeaway is just hunting the good stuff, looking at the positive in any situation. It's also going to help me be a better family man. I have 3 children at home, and I'm also an NCO, which means I have subordinates under me. So it's going to help me to develop them by developing me first.
At the end of the course, classmates were invited to a horse stable in Gaithersburg, Maryland for an introduction to equine therapy. For the Maryland National Guard, I'm Sergeant Chaz Kibler.